بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we come close to the middle of the month of Ramadan, we come to read in the Quran in these أجزاء the 13, 14, 15. And I think we are close to reach Surah Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. This surah سميت after Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام because in it his history and his struggle to invite people to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. It started that Allah Almighty sent this book, the Quran, to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so he will be able to bring his people, to bring the Arabs from the darkness of the ignorance that they were in to the light of Iman and Islam and to know their Creator. When he said, Alif Lam Ra, Kitabun أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور بإذن ربهم إلى صراط العزيز الحميد. This straight path that would lead us to our success in this life and in the hereafter. And as we read this beautiful surah, we come to know Ibrahim, the hero of da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he went first to his father and invite him to Islam and Iman with a gentle, kind word, the word Ya Abati, O my father. And he repeated this many times. And his father was, in a way, treating him badly. And he threatened him to expel him from his house if he doesn't stop what he is saying. And then he let them be and went to his people. And he asked them, how come you worship these idols, which does not bring you any good and does not prevent you from any harm? And you leave Allah, the creator of the universe, who created you and made everything available to you. And they also rejected him. And the Sayyidina Ibrahim, he was steadfast with sabr and determination and power to continue his journey, inviting people to Allah. And he went to the leader, the king of his time, and Namrud, and he invited him to Allah. And in the dialogue between Ibrahim and the king, he said, if you say your Lord, give life and take life, the king also can give life and take life. And when he explored that, he said, bring two prisoners, send one of them to be killed and send the other one free. He said, you see, I give that life to this one and I took life from the other one. And with the intelligence of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he told the king, my Lord, bring the sun from the east. If you are God, bring the sun from the west. فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ. At that time, where the arrogant king, instead of giving up and believing in Allah Almighty, he continued to be in his arrogance and threatened Ibrahim to be killed with the fire. And you know the rest of the story, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the fire to be بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا ala Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Now when we look at this story, and compare it to the story and the history of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who invited his family first, and he called them to worship Allah, not the idols around the Kaaba, and to go back to worship Allah and Allah alone without shirk, without associating any of these idols with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he invited his family, he invited his people around Mecca and in the Arabian Peninsula. Even he went on to the world to tell people about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ. Each messenger came to his people with their own language so they can understand what they are being told. لِيُبَيِّنَا لَهُمْ. So each prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to the Arabs, but he was mercy to mankind, mercy to all humanity. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna arsalnaka bashiran wa nadhira, giving glad tiding and a warning to your people, and وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Your message is a mercy to mankind and to jinn kind. العالمين عالم الإنس وعالم الجن. Excuse me. So those who responded to Allah's invitation through the message of Sayyidina Ibrahim and the message of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were grateful to Allah, thankful to Allah, and as a result of that, they deserve the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Ibrahim told his people, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَا رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. The more grateful you are, the more I will give you out of your provision and out of the mercy and the forgiveness. وَلَئِن كَفَرْتُمْ. And if you reject the message of Ibrahim and if you reject the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my punishment is very painful. إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And as you read this beautiful surah, you see how many dua Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam said to make his people more comfortable with the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he said, Rabbi ij'al hadha baladan aminan, make this town of Mecca secure with peace. And when he put his family around the Kaaba, he said, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ. In a place where there is no vegetation, there is no water, no food. As you order me, O Allah, I did. So make the heart of the people willing to come and visit with them and give them provision from all kinds of blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, Rabbana innaka ta'lamu ma nukhfi wa ma nu'lin. O Allah, you know what we keep in secret and what we declare in public. O Allah, help us to be better human being on earth. And he made his famous dua for his family and to keep a prayer, their prayer, able to elevate them, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-salatu mi'rajul mu'min. As you pray and you say Allahu Akbar, you are ascending with your soul, with your ruh, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, سيدنا إبراهيم إن هز دعاء رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. Oh Allah, make me among those who perform prayers and do their duty to their prayers so their prayer will be accepted. Similarly, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in riwayati sahih Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah that a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said إِذَا حَافَظَ الْعَبْدُ عَلَى صَلَاتِهِ, that when you are taking care of your prayer, how? Prophet explained. He said, فَأَقَامَ وُضُوءَهَا, he performed his wudu and performed his qiyam and ruku' and sujood and qira'ati al-Qur'an, understand what he is reading in his prayer. The prayer itself would tell that mu'min who praying, she will tell him, حَفِظَكَ اللَّهُ كَمَا حَفِظْتَنِي, Allah will preserve you as you preserve your prayers. أَنْ تَصْعَدْ الْمَلَائِكَ بِصَلَاتِهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, the angels will take this salah and ascend to the heaven, and with it the enlightenment of nur, and when it reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, سبحانه فتشفع لصاحبها, this prayer, the perfect one, it will ask Allah Almighty to intercede for this person who preserved his salah and perfected his salah. So dear brothers, as you pray, make sure that your mind is in the salah, not in something else occupied. Make sure you understand what you read. When you say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, you are praising Allah. And Allah said, my slave, my servant is praising me. When you say, Rabbil Alameen, Allah would say, my servant is giving me and admitting that I am the Lord of the universe. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, the merciful, the mercy given. Rabbil Alameen, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Allah would say, Majjadani Abdi. And then you ask Allah dua. You say, Allah, you alone we worship, and from you alone we seek help. Guide us the straight path, the path of those that you love, المؤمنون, not the path of those who neglected your order and stayed away from Sirat al-Mustaqim, neither those who are misguided. So as we pray and understand what we are praying, we are protecting our salah, and our salah will ask forgiveness to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let's take advantage of this beautiful surah, Surah Ibrahim, and take advantage of the month of Ramadan, so we will be able to come near to perfecting our siyam and our salah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه يغفر لكم فيا فوز المستغفرين لا تنسونا من دعائكم جزاكم الله خيراً.